What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Today we're going to talk about 0 to 100. 0 to 100 is real. Yeah, it's real. Real fucking stupid. Shit dumb, man. Basically, I'm going to use a few examples of 0 to 100 just to give you the idea of how dumb that shit is. And if you believe in it, please stop. Don't. That's no. Mm-mm. Everybody need a medium. Everything needs a medium. 0 to 100 is bad. Okay, prime example. Take a kid that's going to school every day and he getting bullied, right? And he is 0. He don't say nothing back. He don't say nothing back. Then he goes shoot the fucking school up. 0 to 100. Ends really bad. Okay, let's just say you got a car and it goes from 0 to 100. Nothing in between 0 to 100. How the fuck you gonna drive through traffic? As soon as you touch the gas, that bitch doing 100 miles per hour. And then as soon as you press the brake, it go back to 0. You need something that can do the numbers in between, right? Okay. Now, got one. Another. Boss. You got a boss. You always at 0. Your boss always talking to you. Blah, 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 this, that, and this. If you use the 50, you would have understood that I could talk to my boss, let this person know that he's being disrespectful, he's crowding my space, and this is the reason why these things are happening. But you wait, and then next thing you know, you slapping his ass in the face with a doctor statement like, I got overactive bowel. In them in the face with it. Now, guess what? The turnover rate in that place, they probably went from 0 to 100 just because of shit just like that. And last but not least, I got a true story that I want to tell. I got a big brother. He a big brody ass. Man, he big shit. We call everybody, the family call him Romo. But his name on Facebook is Go Harder Than Most. We call him Romo because the football player Tony Romo, of course. So we call him Romo. His name Tony. One day, I decided that now I'm going to go over to Chicago. Go out to Chicago to see my brother. So we jump in the car. We go to Chicago. I go down bro crib. Now, when I go to Chicago, I got my PPE with me. For people who don't know what PPE is, PPE is personal protective equipment. I have my gun on me. So you know what I'm saying? I always take my gun for protection. For the most part, I keep my gun on me. Now, we go in, we get talking, reminiscing, look drinking, talk stuff. Everybody get tired. We all go to bed. True story. So I'm laying down in the bed chilling. Birds start chirping and all that, and I'm still sleeping through it. Next thing you know, I hear, man, I don't get no fuck. Yeah, all right, watch this shit. I'm like, oh, shit, somebody in the house. Somebody got to be in the house. First thing I do is go for what? My PPE. So I go for the PPE like, man, somebody got in the house. Let me go check out bro and make sure he's safe. He's standing in the middle of the kitchen floor with a box of cereal called Kabooms. And he got a knife. And he's stabbing the cereal box while he's talking stuff to it. I cannot make this up. And he totally pissed. He pissed off. He turning red. You know how hard it is to make a black man turn red. He turning red. Fuck you. I don't care. I swear to God, you're going to do it for me. And he's stabbing it. And all that. To make a long story short, somebody called the police. They came in. We had to fill out reports. People had to witness it, blah, blah, blah. It was yellow tape all in the kitchen. The Kaboom box was laid out on the floor. Marshmallows everywhere. And to make a long story short, the part that kind of got me and him is when his daughter walked in the room. She was like, what happened, Uncle Toon? Why is yellow tape in the kitchen? And I ain't want her to know it was her pops. So I was like, well, you know the box of Kabooms that was on the refrigerator? She was like, yeah. I was like, it tried to hurt your cousins. She was like, it did. I was like, yeah. So I had to take it out. Now, all the time that's happening, I'm looking at Tony like, see, 0 to 100 is bad. I'm just going to make this very short because then I got to do a few shout outs. 0 to 100 is very bad. Business people say there's no emotions in business. This is the serious part. OGs say, real G's don't deal with feelings and emotions. Anger is an emotion. So if you're always angry, you're a very emotional human being. Last but not least, I had to write out a list. Khalil Buford, Thomas El Guapo Cole, Picasso Stalin, Brandon Webb, Cassandra Demus, Brian Thomas, Tequila Perry, Michael Barber, Anthony Newman. Those are the people that honestly been helping me behind the scenes to make sure and continuously give me good ideas, fresh ideas, nice quotes, and helping me to make YBE grow. I want to send y'all a shout out, man. From the bottom of my heart, man, I appreciate y'all, man. I swear to God, I appreciate y'all for believing in me and believing in something that's bigger than all of us. You know what I'm saying? So I just wanted to let y'all know that, man. I really appreciate. Oh yeah, Hubert Jones too. I'm sorry, Hubert Jones too. Behind the scenes, like, thanks for helping me, man. Thanks for giving me fresh ideas. Thanks for doing the stuff behind the scenes that you do. It ain't going without appreciation, man. I really appreciate it. Thank y'all so much. And that's from the bottom of my heart. And just like a philosopher said on Bad Boy 2, that's not gay shit. That's man shit. for real though, man. I really appreciate it though. Ending with the slogan because I'm going long. You don't want to end up in a box. Think outside of it. YBE.